Today's finalists grabbing that final spot, last year's Player of the Year, Parker Bohn III, in the number seven position in search of his third victory, Steve Wilson. Qualifying number six, trying to make it back-to-back victories, Norm Duke. Our fifth-seeded player, he won 2 weeks ago, Ryan Shafer. In the number four spot, five-time PBA titleist, Tim Criss. Qualifying number three, it's been a year since he last won, Jason Hurd. Our number two-seeded player, he made 10 shows a year ago, Jason Couch. And our tournament leader, outstanding regional player, now trying to win on the national tour, John May. Today we're at Holiday Bowl Brainerd as eight players battle for the championship. It's the PBA Chattanooga Open. Hi everyone, I'm Phil Ferguson along with my broadcast partner, 22-time PBA winner Marshall Holman up here in the booth. And Marsh, first round match. You've got a couple of future Hall of Famers going against a player who hasn't won in over 3 years.
Well, it looks like a mismatch with Duke or Bohn probably winning, but don't count out Steve Wilson, who is quite a player in his own right. Duke in the first frame.
The Centennial gets the 7-pin to kick out.
A good quality shot from Duke.
Of course, Norm won just a week ago, an emotional win, hometown of Dallas. Now look at Steve Wilson, 31 years old. He too finds the pocket.
You know, the scores were not that high this week. A lot of trouble carrying, but so far, our first two competitors, 10 in the pit for both of them.
Parker Bohn, the third PBA Player of the Year, won five titles last year out of Jackson, New Jersey.
Well, the stylist Parker Bohn, the third. Very familiar with that looking routine.
So demanding lane condition this week.
Well, it was. You know, our top seed just averaged a little over 220. The rest of the competitors in the high 210s, so certainly not the high scores we've been expecting and been seeing in the previous weeks.
Duke from Claremont, Florida, trying to start off this opening match with a double.
Solid shot from Duke. The right-hand lane for the right-handers hooks quite a bit more. For the left-handers, the left-hand lane hooks more.
Wilson's second shot. Little hitch to start things off. Bring it back and just the 10 pin.
Well, we saw a lot of that during the match play portion of the tournament yesterday. A lot of 10 pins left for the right-handed players.
Bohn with 22 titles. Huh. Tied somebody I know sitting very close to me with 22.
He's getting ready to pass me. Well, Wilson makes a spare in the left-hand lane.
As we take a look at the scoreboard now, after two frames, a couple of players starting off with doubles, and Wilson just that 10-pin.
Yeah, that 10-pin cost him 10 pins to both Duke and Bohn.
And Duke won a thrilling match last week over Steve Jarrus in Dallas, 267 to 266. Up in the third frame.
Duke didn't like the way he released that ball. Ball came in high, leaving the 6-10. Fortunately, not splitting.
Wilson takes some time, kind of curls up that pinky finger.
A little more leverage.
Will it pay off?
Well, fortunate, just the 4-pin. Lane's a little tougher this week. The conditioner went down 36 feet, and it's a little flatter, not as much of a crown.
No problem for Duke on the spare in the third frame. 48 through 2 for Duke, and now Wilson trying to pick up the 4-pin in the third. Parker Bohn starting off with a double. He struggled in practice. I was watching him, Marshall.
Well, he seems to have figured it out so far. two great opening shots, this to take a 12-pin lead over Duke. Not much struggling for Parker Bohn III. Five tournament victories last year. And with shots like this, you see that high arm swing straight. Beautiful trajectory down the lane. High flush into the pocket. Parker Bohn III.
Get the power of Proactive only from Brunswick. By Ginkoba. Ginkoba helps improve memory and concentration. Think better. Think Ginkoba. And by Pfizer, where life is our life's work. There's a look at the scoreboard right now. Parker Bohn III, three straight strikes, leads by 12 over Norm Duke, 21 in front of Steve Wilson, fourth frame.
Just does trip out the four-pin, 10-pin stance, and that's the lane that Norm chose to finish on. As the sixth qualifier, he had the choice of lanes.
Wilson, great regional player, 12 regional titles, a couple of national championships.
Solid release from Wilson. Doesn't want to let Parker Bohn get away too quickly.
One of the best spinner shooters in the game. Duke picks up that 10 pin. So now Bohn has come out here in the opening match with three in a row. He won five titles last year, 11 television appearances.
Dominant year. And a dominant strike in the fourth frame. Well, that's five in a row from Parker Bohn, and excuse me, four in a row for Parker Bohn. He knows he's in command right now.
So Duke, after the spare in the fifth frame, sending it out. And boy, he's having some problems, Marshall.
Well, he started out, you know, with a couple of really nice strikes and just has not been able to find the release and proper speed to get the ball into the pocket.
Wilson trying to make it a double. Close the gap to 21. Should he strike?
Gotta hurry. Now trips the two pin out, but leaves the eight. And right now for Duke and Wilson, spares aren't going to get it done.
Duke, no problem with the single pin spare. Wilson also trying to pick up the spare. In the fifth frame. Now, Parker Bohn. He has started off this opening match with the first four.
Well, I gave him the fifth one a little while ago, inadvertently. Let's see if he can do it for real.
That's five in a row for Parker Bohn, and he is in command. Up by 41 over Steve Wilson, Duke down by 34.
Now let's take a look at what's in the bag. And for Parker Bohn, it's the Parker Bohn MVP. This ball gives Parker an arc reaction from the mid lane. And the ball shines so Parker can stand further left and stay up the lane. The Parker Bohn MVP provides a strong but smooth reaction, and the layout is a 4.5-inch pin with a weight hold 2.5 inches down from his axis point. And he is making it work. Target zone is his spare ball, but hasn't needed it so far.
Five strikes for Bohn, the leader. Duke in the sixth.
That looks better. He's not ready to just call it quits right now. Duke making a quality shot in the sixth frame.
Methodical Steve Wilson now up in the sixth, and he's got to get it going. He has a couple of strikes, but three spares to go along with it.
And very similar to the reaction he had on lane 30, ball coming in light, this time leaving the 2, 4, and 8. And there's the man right now with the big lead and looking to increase it.
First five recently engaged. Maybe that's helped his game a little bit too. Leslie Beamish, congratulations. Like to win here. Six in a row. He's halfway there, Marshall.
Well, he's bowled 300 before. He's halfway there today.
Extra 10,000, courtesy of the PBA, should he toss a 300. Wilson picks up a very difficult spare, so he hangs in this opening match. So
Parker Bohn III doing what he's been doing the whole game. High flush in the pocket, taking care of business with a commanding lead.
With the first six, Marshall.
And it's up to this man to try and cut into that lead right now. He's working on a strike. Can chop it down to 34 pins with a strike on 29. Oh, he just loved it off his hand. He knew it was there. Solid 10, 6-pin right around the bottom of the 10-pin. Not looking good for Norm or, for that matter, Steve Wilson right now, who can't do much about what Parker's doing.
And a ringing 10. Not much you can do. Throw the shot. Come on back. Pick up the spare. Duke. No problem with the 10 pin.
Well, Wilson knocked the 10 pin down. Didn't get much of it, but here's the man right now. And look at those averages from last year. He shattered the all-time leading average for a year with a 228-plus average.
7 in a row, down on one knee. Oh, my, he is red hot here in Chattanooga.
Parker showed a little bit of power. Watch as the ball hits the 5-pin. Bang! Head pin goes to the sideboard. Strong strike, and I think he liked it.
Duke up in the 8. Brings it back, and
solid 8. And that's got to bring a smile to Duke, a smile of, what do you have to do?
And we did have a 300 here last year. Steve Jarris, who recorded the perfect game, went on to win the championship. Wilson with the strike. Wife Sherry, and Duke picks up the spare.
Right now, the best that Duke can shoot is 225. That's Wilson can shoot 225, and Parker's just having a good old time with 7 in a row, 5 more for another 300.
8th frame.
Will it go? He trips out the 6 and the 8. Everything going Parker Bohn's way. Ball a little bit right off his hand. It's going to hook high into the 1-2 pocket. There goes the 6-pin. The 8-pin, it gets kicked out. Oh, thank you.
I think you know he has the match pretty well in hand, and Parker Bohn now with the first 8 here in the opening shootout. There's the score right now, and certainly Bohn in command.
Well, right now, for Bohn, it's all about trying to keep this 300 game going. He certainly does have this match won, but can he become the first in PBA history to bowl 2 300 games on national television?
Some fun now. Duke in the 9.
And these guys are just trying to get out of Parker's way right now. They'd love to strike to give Parker some momentum so he can get up there and throw his shot.
Now for Wilson, he has a nice start to this year. Third top 24 appearance. Just that 10-pin.
And there's Sherry Wilson. Pleased to see hubby Steve make the telecast, but I'd like to see a little more of striking.
And their daughter Sarah, she'll be 1-year-old February 11th coming up, so happy early birthday as he picks up the 10-pin. Well, Bohn now has the first 8 up in the 9th, and the crowd has really been getting into this one.
The last couple of shots, a little bit light on lane 29, a little bit high on 30. We'll see how he handles the pressure. applause. Quite a performance. There's the spare ball.
It works too.
Not a bad shot, Marshall.
No, he made a very good shot. Right down the five board, hooking into the 1-2 pocket. Watch the four pin. It's going to go around the bottom of the seven. And the disappointment. He wanted that one.
They'll be thinking now about the next match. Steve Wilson and Norm Duke will finish out their opening.
Wilson able to get one in a row on a few occasions. Can he break the 200 mark?
Duke, the 1994 PBA Player of the Year, after winning five titles that year, is off to a nice start here in 2000. He won last week, and Wilson hasn't won in over 3 years, Marshall, but he'll be back.
Well, as you said earlier, he's made three top 24s in a row and certainly making a lot of quality shots. Looks like it should be a good year. 195 will be the best for Wilson.
Duke can shoot 201 with a strike. And, all right, 201 for Duke, but it's Parker Bohn's game. As Wilson will finish out.
And very important for Bohn to keep the concentration up. Wants to make a quality shot here. Get ready for the next match.
And it's one. Possible 279. Marshall, I get a lot of comments back home about the gold pins.
Well, they're a little tougher to knock down, as Parker Bohn certainly is the winner of match one. They're a few ounces heavier, and the bottoms of the pins are pretty flat, so they don't fly around as fast as the lighter wood.
Not tough for Parker, though. As he gets another one. Oh, just that ninth frame. Give it to me back.
You can see he's a little disappointed, but actually not shooting 300 may work in his advantage as far as this game is concerned, this next match coming up, because, when you shoot 300, you lose a lot of energy. He should be fine for the next match.
And for Bohn, there it is. Oh, what a performance. In match one, Parker Bohn III with a 279. So Bohn will move on now to our second shootout, and it will be against Tim Criss and Ryan Shafer. Back with that match in a minute. Welcome to Holiday Bowl Brainerd here in Chattanooga. It's the PBA Chattanooga Open, and what an exciting opening round match. Parker Bohn III with that 279. Hi, I'm Phil Ferguson, along with my broadcast partner, Marshall Holman. And Parker Bohn, give me that ninth frame back.
Oh, boy. You know, he just dominated. This is what he did last year in 1999, the year 2000. Parker's goal is to be back-to-back PBA Player of the Year. And with shots like this, he's got a heck of a good chance to do it. Just classic Parker Bohn III. And he loves it.
Well, he had 11 strikes in the opening match. We still have some heavy hitters coming up, Marshall. And don't overlook the guy on the top.
Well, absolutely. John May, who is a regional player who's now on the national tour, he's never won on the national level, but I like his chances. He keeps the ball in play. He knows what it takes to get the job done. Also, Jason Couch, certainly, after 10 telecasts last year, winning the Tournament of Champions, getting himself to be one of the top players on tour, he has a good chance as well. But right now, Parker Bohn III looking to continue his dominance as he enters the second match. Phil, back up to you.
All right, thanks a lot, Marshall. And the initial handshake. Now we have three players. If you're just joining us here on the Pro Bowlers Tour, eight-man finals field. First three matches, three players each. The winner moves on, the championship match, head-to-head. Tim Criss will start off match two. Parker Bohn advanced through the opening shootout with that 279. Criss with a strike to start. He loves to throw it slow, Marshall, let the ball work, and he's able to do it.
Well, that's where he got the nickname, the Turtle. He kind of just crawls the ball down the lane and gets quite a bit of hook on the ball as well. from his hand off the side of the ball. And speaking of hook, watch this guy. Ryan Shafer.
Here comes the messenger, or as they say in Texas, the bird dog, coming over there taking care of business. And a lot of those were actually going in front of the 10 pin and 7 pin, respectively, for the left handers. That one is able to get at the 10 pin.
Bohn with a strike. Oh, he is red hot, and that 8 pin stood up for a moment.
Here's Shafer. He gets the messenger. Watch the 10 pin. Just gets knocked out by the head pin.
All players with strikes.
Landon hooks more, and it goes right through the nose for Criss.
A little too much goose.
And a shot he would definitely like to have back. Shafer won his first title just a couple weeks ago in Las Vegas.
He's getting started off with a strike. Trying to make it two in a row. No problem. Boy. And talking to him last night, Marshall, you could just see the confidence oozing from him because he finally got that monkey off his back after not winning for 14 years.
Absolutely. Criss makes the spare. Well, as if there wasn't enough confidence oozing, this man right here has had nothing but confidence over the last many years.
Just finished this year, 14th in Dallas. So I guess by Parker's standards, he has struggled a bit.
Wow. Ball through the heart. He leaves the 2, 4, 6, 7, 10. And it looks like a big mess, and it is, but he can make this. You see his ball just cutting right through the heart, leaving the 5 pins. Needs to get his ball to the left-hand side of that 2 pin, knock it into the 4, into the 6 pin. As Criss is up on lane 29, leaves the 10 pin. Just like I said, he should do it. Got the ball to the left-hand side of the 2-pin, knocks it into the 6-10.
And Criss picks up the 10-pin. So Ryan Shafer with the early lead through two frames. He has a double. Shafer now up in the third frame. Six regional titles. Of course, he won that his first title just a couple of weeks ago.
That ball slid. Ball accelerated to the right off his hand. Wasn't able to get back to the pocket. It's a 2-pin. You can see it slides out about 3 more boards to the right than it had the previous shot.
Parker right back in the pocket. And Marshall, you brought up during the telecast with the A-Man Finals that the lanes change that...
Well, they change faster. I mean, there's more players bowling. You see Shafer on lane 30 to pick up the 2-pin, and he's become a very good spare shooter. Wasn't early in his career, but with 8 players bowling, it's certainly the oil gets dragged down quicker. As you can see, Criss 10 pins down, Bohn 9 pins down to Shafer.
And it really does give the advantage to the top-seeded player.
Oh, absolutely. Well, it's much more difficult to try and get through an 8-man field than a 5. Ripley numbers game. Look at that ball get towards the channel. But it came back.
Wow.
And even Tim Criss is surprised that he got that one back.
Well, it's nice outside here in Chattanooga and nice inside.
Well, look how far down. It's on the 2 board at 45 feet. Comes back and just rattles him around.
Shafer in the fourth frame.
Solid strike from Shafer. Now, could Parker Bohn make a better shot on lane 30? Remember, he left that wide open split, converted it, but he needs some strikes. Strike here would give him the lead. And still just a little bit high on lane 30. Just the 6-pin.
Criss now trying to make it a double. He's up in the fifth.
Ball creeps up high in the 1-2 pocket. Not able to trip out the 6-pin.
Criss almost hurt the channel last time. Got a strike.
Yeah.
Now Bohn makes the six pin, and I think Criss liked the way that ball looked halfway down the lane on 29, but it didn't make the move back to the 1-2-3 pocket.
Shafer leads by 9 over Bohn, 10 in front of Criss, and he picks up the spare. So Ryan Shafer, your early leader, up in the fifth frame.
Chance to extend on that lead. He struck in the previous frame in the fourth. This is the lane he left the two pin on. He likes to just jump on it. Put a lot of snap in it. Get the ball back to pocket.
Boy, you can see him coming up and really ripping it.
Yep. That's his adjustment when the ball comes in light, is just to give it a little more. He's got it's like a home run hitter who has more in reserve.
It's a Bohn in the fifth frame. Struck previous two times on this lane. Not this time. So he's struggling a bit after that opening 279.
Well, unable to get it going after that great first game. Parker Bohn in the fifth frame, yet to have a double. Almost misses the spare. Parker just barely getting the six pin. Ryan Shafer, he's the one with the lead. He takes care of business on lane 30 with more snap off the wrist. That's how he got it back, and you know he just loved it. 20-pin lead over Criss and Bohn for Ryan Shafer.
I mean, he's won 22 titles, 5 last year, last year's PBA Player of the Year.
Well, it's still anybody's game, Phil. It's, we're just in the sixth frame. 20 pins is not that much of a deficit. Well, you know, we saw this last week with players winning one match and then the next match just struggling. And Parker could do no wrong in the opening game, and now he can't seem to find it.
Criss can cut the lead to 9 with a strike.
Period.
Ball looking high for Criss. Ryan Shafer sitting on the bench. Getting some help from the opposition as Parker Bohn makes the spare in the sixth frame, but doesn't cut into that lead of Ryan Shafer.
Tim Criss trails by 19, Bohn by 20 through 6 frames. Ryan Shafer, your leader.
Hold it.
Now you can hear Tim Criss doing a little play-by-play, wondering if the ball was going to hang on, and it did. As you can see, Criss 19 down. Bohn 20 down. This man's the leader.
You see the confidence. Last night he's ready to go.
Uh-oh. There it is. The 2 and the 10. I said earlier, with the ball coming back at that extreme line, easy to have that company with the 2 pin. Now, Parker Bohn really back in the match, and that may really rejuvenate him. Watch as the ball comes from way right, coming back into the pocket, but light. Not able to do it.
Bohn down the 7th, and he's back in the pocket and gets a strike.
And you just know that shot from Shafer energized Bohn. Should have done the same for Tim Criss.
You can pick it up, can't you, Marsh?
Certainly can be made. Get the ball left of the 2 pin, slide it into the 10. Oh, he overcut it.
Great try.
A super effort.
Shafer with 145 through 7. In fact, Parker Bohn with another strike can take the lead. Bohn down by 7, Criss down by 6. So that open really has brought everybody in this match. Criss way out, brings it back.
It's a 2-pin for Criss. The ball's hanging for the right-handers. And Bohn not having a lot of success on the left side either.
Shafer up in the 8th after that open.
Scores were not high this week. Very demanding lane condition. Did Shafer bounce back? Nope. Leaves the 8 pin.
Now Parker up in the 8th. Just a minute. We got to see Criss. Spare. And Jim, congratulations. Just his second tournament. Just had a baby. Congratulations. A Miranda, born January. So for Tim Criss, he's only bowled a couple of stops. The spare for Ryan Shafer, but now Parker Bohn.
We'll see how Parker Bohn handles the pressure here in our second match. Opportunity to take the lead on a lane he's been high on. Boy, he loved that one. Aggressive shot from Parker Bohn III. You know, when you have a game like this, you've got to be able to trust it. Bohn certainly does. Positive reaction.
And now after eight frames, Parker Bohn is on top by three over Ryan Shafer and Tim Criss by 10. Show your PBA loyalty by becoming a member of the PBA Fan Club. Fan Club members receive quarterly newsletters, which include the latest inside information on the PBA tours, tips and interviews with the pros, discounts on PBA merchandise, contests, and much more. Membership just $14.95 plus $3 shipping and handling, and includes a PBA decal. For more information or to join, call 1-888-440-1340. Tim Criss gets the strike in the night.
He tickled him over, Phil. Very light in the pocket, but they're all gone. And that sets him up for a possible 218. Ryan Shafer, if he were to strike out, he could shoot 225.
Shafer in the ninth.
Well, he slowed the speed down, but still can't get the ball to break back up into the pocket. Another two-pin for Ryan Shafer.
Well, Parker Bohn, easy win with that 279 in match one. Struggled really for five frames here in match two, but now has a double and has the lead.
And if he strikes here, he controls his own destiny, and it's going into the 10th frame. We'll hold. Oh, yeah.
Oh, my.
Parker Bohn with that strike. What a beautiful shot. Right in the pocket. He knows he can't be shut out.
Shafer picks up the spare in the ninth. So now we're moving into the 10th frame, Marshall.
Well, very important for Tim Criss. This is a situation for him. If he strikes out in the 10th frame, he could shoot 218. As you can see, he's 20 pins down. He can take care of that deficit by striking these next three shots. That would force Parker Bohn to strike his first ball in the 10th to win the match.
Flush it, flush it.
Ball crept in high. Thought he had it. Ryan Shafer must strike out to have any chance. He can shoot 214 and force Bohn to mark in the 10th frame. And sitting on the bench, Parker Bohn, having things going his way.
Chris with the spare, Bohn just sitting there saying, hey.
He's saying thank you, I think. Shafer with a possible 203, Chris with a possible 198. Parker needs just to show up in the 10th frame. If he gets eight on his first ball and then get one, and he would have plenty.
Ryan Shafer, boy, he looked red hot through five frames and then by a strike from the 6th frame on. And now Tim Criss with a strike, but it is a 198 for Criss.
Now, these are the kind of scores that we've seen all week long, Phil. And it seems like just when you feel like you've got something figured out, the lanes change a little bit, and you have to adjust. That's what Parker's done.
Shafer with a 203.
Parker gets 9 on his first ball. He's your winner. You got to like his chances, don't you?
I like it. Since you said so, you're the boss. Here it comes, and oh, yeah, Parker Bohn. He has won match two. Oh, what an exciting match here. Parker Bohn comes through, and we'll head now to the semifinal match. Parker Bohn now in command in Chattanooga as he has won two matches. Six straight strikes to end the match. 238, he moves on. Ryan Shafer with a 203 and Tim Criss a 198. Now, here is this week's score more with Brunswick Tip. Marshall continues to look at the bowling ball.
Last week we found my access point. Now Ray Edwards is here to help me use that information to create different reactions from the same ball.
Yeah, Marshall, what we have here is we have two balls that are started out exactly the same, but because we've drilled them differently, they're going to give you very different reactions on the lane. In this ball here, you'll notice that this marking pin on the surface of the ball is very far away from your axis. What that shows us is that the core is at a 90-degree angle relative to your axis in that ball, and that's going to create a very stable axis. It's going to create very little flare. It's going to give you a real gentle reaction of the ball on the lane. In the second example, we've chosen a different drilling pattern that puts the core at a different angle relative to your axis. In this case, the core is at a 45-degree angle, which is a very unstable position, causing the track to flare as the ball goes down the lane. You'll see the axis tape go off the axis quickly, and you'll get much more reaction of the ball in the back end of the lane.
Well, now that I have this information, I can take it to my local ball driller, and we can set up particular bowling balls to get the reactions that I'm looking for.
Oh, I always learn something with Marshall in the tip of the week. Next three stops, next Sunday, 12 o'clock, Parker Bohn III Empire State Open. The following week, the PBA National Championship gets underway at 12:30 at Southwick Lanes in Toledo. Then the Bayer Brunswick Touring Players Championship at Freddie Borden's Place, Stone Age Family Fun Center in Akron. Parker Bohn III has won two matches, and he now moves on, and he will take on Jason Hurd and Jason Couch in our semifinal match from Chattanooga.
Look at this. Over 1 million stomachs have gotten tighter with 8-minute abs. And to
Parker Bohn has done it so far, but Jason Couch, Jason Hurd up next.
Well, it looked like Bohn was certainly struggling in the last match. Figured it out. You know, you've got to be versatile out here and be able to make adjustments. Couch, a power player on the left side, and certainly heard the power player on the right. Fortunate, only the two, the six, excuse me, the three, the six, and the nine.
First look at Jason Hurd, 24-year-old power player. Wow.
Yeah, that's a good word to describe Jason Hurd. Wow. He really drives the ball back into the pocket. Tough spare.
Picks it up. So a spare for Couch in the first. Hurd with a strike. And now Parker Bohn. Fans really behind Parker now.
Well, easy to get behind Parker Bohn. He's certainly been the best player on tour in the last couple of years, as evidenced by his great 1999 season. And a much straighter trajectory than what you'll see from the other lefty, Jason Couch. Parker going much more directly down the boards.
Couch, 10 TV appearances last year. Parker Bohn with 11. But Couch, 223,000 plus. That's second. 225 plus average. That's second. 19 cashes, third. And if it were not for Parker, he probably would have been player of the year.
Much better shot on lane 30 for Couch. Watch the high, you see the high backswing and the ball making the hard charge from the left-hand side and confidence.
Jason Hurd, here you go.
You don't see Hurd leave too many soft 10 pins with his ball trucking back so fast into the 1-3 pocket. Usually trips him out, but it'll be no better than a spare in the second for Jason Hurd.
Bohn making his 76th television appearance, 55 and 55, with a better than 221 average, and trying to start off with two in a row. Hurd ranked 40th. PBA computer rankings picks up the spare.
Well, I see this as a very, very key shot for Jason Couch.
Early on in the match, huh?
Yeah, well, he came in light the first time on lane 29. It really needs to put the pressure on Parker Bohn. Did everything he needed to do except
good
knock
job.
The seventh pin down. Watch the four pin, second from the left. It'll go around the bottom of the seven pin, and it's a great shot, but only nine.
Hurd strikes bare to start this semifinal match.
And another soft 10 for Hurd.
Third by the PBA. And picks it up.
Yeah, it changed balls, went to a harder surface ball, and it's a good thing because he just barely did clip the seven pin.
Now Hurd, he won just about a year ago, a little over a year ago. His only PBA title as he picks up the spare. Boy, good-looking young player, though, and Higgins, when he starts striking, look out. Most players out here on tour, and Parker Bohn now has two in a row. Started off with a 279 the opening game. 238 match two, and now here in the semifinal match. Finished off that second game with six straight strikes.
Well, he's found it. Three in a row for Parker Bohn. Parker Bohn III coming in just a tad light. He's going to rattle him around. Now he's starting to get all the good breaks.
Three in a row. And for Parker, he is on top by 21 over Jason Hurd. The first Winter X Games on the East Coast takes ESPN and ESPN2 viewers to Mount Snow, Vermont. Coverage continues tonight on ESPN at 9 p.m. with a highlight show at midnight, and tomorrow on ESPN2 at 9 p.m. with highlights at midnight. ESPN.com, part of the Go Network, Go.com. Boy, exciting Winter X Games.
Well, I'm a skiing enthusiast, so I love the Winter X Games, and I wouldn't want to try anything that they do, but boy, fun to watch. A lot of aerial stuff. Just scary.
Couch spare, strike spare up in the fourth. You had mentioned he's got to get it going. Parker has the first three.
Well, Couch has made great shots the last two, but unable to knock the seven pin down.
Hurd taking a little extra time, and he's got to get going after a strike and a couple of spares up in the fourth.
Well, Hurd down by 21, Couch down by 20, and Parker perfect so far. Will that knock it? No. Well, it's three 10 pins in a row. However, that is of a different variety. That's the fortuitous 10 pin.
Couch going after the 7 pin.
And Hurd going for three in a row, but unfortunately that's three 10-pin conversions in a row.
Hurd shot a 280, his high game of the week. Low 163 on this TV pair, at 216 average. And picks up the spare. Now Parker Bohn up in the fourth frame with three strikes. Doing something a little bit to his thumb hole.
Just trying to maintain a good feel. Very important for the players to keep the feel of the ball just right. Will it hold? Here comes the... Oh, doesn't quite get the seven pin.
Boy, that hit it from behind or in front, but just wouldn't fall over.
Watch the head pin go to the sideboard. Call it a bird dog, call it a messenger. But this time, don't call it Parker Bohn's friend. It does not knock down the seven.
We're in Chattanooga. It's got to be the choo-choo or something. Picks up that seven pin spare. So Parker Bohn, after three in a row and a spare, still leads by 20 over Couch, 21 in front of Hurd. Fifth frame.
You better carry. Yeah. Don't go anywhere. Don't go anywhere.
That was directed right at Parker Bohn, but Couch says don't go anywhere. This one got to the pocket and knocked down the seven pin for Jason Couch. Now can the other Jason strike? Oh, ball drove right through the nine pin. He throws up his arms as if to say, what do you have to do?
That nine pin laughing at him.
Oh, so much power.
Now for Parker, he's got to come back here in the fifth frame. Still leading here in the semifinal match.
Quiet confidence from Parker Bohn III. Now Hurd makes the spare.
Bird picks up the spare. Jason Couch coming up with a powerful strike in the fifth.
You better carry. Yeah. Don't go.
Jason Couch. Oh, it's not over yet. Back with more in a minute. Trying to make it a double and cut that lead to 10.
Well, they're very, very good friends. They're roommates, and
but they don't want to forget about Jason Hurd.
Well, they haven't.
Hurd, four spares in a row, but he's around the pocket.
That time the nine pin falls over. That's right. I'm still here too. He says.
Almost another nine pin, Marshall.
But you'll watch the ball drive right past. The ball will not touch the nine pin. But for a Hurd, fortunately, something else does. It's about time something good happened.
Bohn up now in the sixth. Oh, yeah.
Solid strike for Parker Bohn.
Friendly rivalry.
Well, it was a 10-pin lead. Now it's back to 20.
Couch with a double. Just watching it.
Solid seven once
again.
What,
did you buy these pens?
Hurd up in the seventh, trying to make it two in a row. Get right back in it.
Well, 3-9-10 split for Hurd, and it's going to make his job that much more difficult as Parker Bohn continues to dominate this match as well.
Couch picks up the seven pin. Difficult spare for Hurd. In fact,
he needs to put the ball in between the 3 and the 10. The ball should drive out and get the 9. He has the power to make it. But light leaving the 3 pin.
Now maybe it is just a 2-horse race with Bohn on top and up now in the 7th frame. 3 strikes to start this match, a spare and a double.
That ball was just so far right off his hand. Just an error. The opportunity to make it a 31-pin lead. Now it's going to be 19. Ball never got far enough to the left, Phil, and went right through the nose. Fortunate just to leave the 4 and the 7.
You had mentioned a little straighter trajectory for Parker, but just kind of pulled it. And now Couch on a spare up in the 8th.
Speed was slower on that delivery. Ball hooked high.
Bohn has been sparkling so far and picks up the spare.
Well, Parker, he'd be the first to admit, he was very fortunate on both those shots. First, he didn't split. As you can see, Parker's got Couch by 19 and Hurd by 42. But Bohn actually made 2 poor shots in that last frame. Got away with it, got the spare.
Well, Hurd, who picked up a win last year, the National Bowling Stadium National Senior Doubles with partner Johnny Petraglia. Way out. And way back.
And that's where Jason Hurd wants his ball to hit to take advantage of the power that he has.
Possible 215 for Jason Hurd, but it's really Bohn right now, up in the 8th. Bohn has won the first 2 matches, trying to get to that title game.
Much better. And there's the bird dog coming hard from the right. Headpin's going to go to the sideboard and then get back in a big hurry. Oh, yeah.
That's the strike in the eighth for Bohn, and he leads by 20 over Couch, 42 in front of Jason Hurd. Check out the PBA's website for schedules of upcoming events in Latham, New York, Toledo, and Akron, Ohio. The website also features the latest Bowler's Journal articles, Bowling's bookstore information about joining the tour, and a recap of today's championship round. All that and more at pbatour.com. Couch, big deep breath.
Must strike. Almost leads a solid eight. Great shot from Couch. Still putting some pressure on Bohn.
Couch with possible 227.
And the best that this man can do, Jason Hurd, will be at 215. Still an outside chance, but he would need some help. And he doesn't get any help from the six pin as it flies around the bottom of the 10 for the ringing 10. It won't happen for Jason Hurd today, but Parker Bohn, he can tack 10 more pins to that lead with a strike here in the ninth frame.
Pulled it on this lane last frame. Eight count, picked up the spare.
He didn't pull that one, Phil. The familiar form of Parker Bohn III, the ball rolling into the 1-2 pocket. Kicking out the 7-pin. Pleased.
Jason Couch up now in the 10th frame.
Now Jason gets you 227. That would force Parker Bohn to mark in the 10th frame.
And Couch has been stung a number of times in this game.
He's made some good shots and been wrapped a lot. That one carried.
All right.
I guess.
Again, you force a player to get a spare, not always easy.
Well, you want to make him do something in the 10th frame, and Couch needs one more. We see Jason Hurd on lane 29 finishing out his game. Sure, now they fall.
Bohn looks at the score. And Couch knows the score. Knows he needs this one
for really any chance. All right. He's still in there. Now, still important for him to strike here. Strike here would give him 227. That would force Bohn to mark. He needs, as you can see, the ball coming into the pocket, high flush, and Couch has made a lot of good shots this game. Carey hasn't been always there.
Jason Hurd finishing up his game, and Couch now with a possible 227 with a strike here.
Well, that'll be enough to force Parker Bohn III to mark in the 10th frame. 226 for Couch.
Boy, Couch has to feel like he deserved a 250 or 260 in that game.
But Carey was not easy this week.
All right, Jason, three in a row, 195. Couch, 226. Now Parker Bohn with a mark can move to the title match. And he was the eighth seed in this tournament. Came through in the last few games last night.
Any kind of mark.
Oh, my!
Well, a little help from above from Parker Bohn as that ball was very light in the pocket. Could have left all sorts of things, but tickled them all down. And now Parker Bohn III will indeed go against John May. And John May looking for his first title. He could have had an easier opponent.
So Parker Bohn, another strike. And he has just steamrolled now through three matches. And Parker Bohn III, last year's PBA Player of the Year, will meet John May. May looking for his first ever PBA title. Open. And we are just about set for the title match. Parker Bohn, that big 279 in match one, match two, 238, and then just shot a 256. He's averaging 257 for three games.
Well, he's the dominator. Let's take a look at some of the other finishers. There's Brian Voss, who's come so close the past few weeks, but hasn't been able to seal the deal to get onto television. Chris Barnes, who's had a great run, didn't quite make it this week, still nursing that broken toe. Patrick Healy Jr., now bowling out of Mexico City, having a good week. Robert Smith, 2,300 games, but too many other low games to get there. The great Pete Weber had trouble in the morning yesterday. Mike Edwards, finishing in 20th place. Randy Peterson, after a few weeks off, making his presence known again. And Dave Watka and Sean Quinn, they wrap up the top 24.
All right, boy. That's what they're shooting for. Parker Bohn, I'll tell you what, a tough task ahead for John May, first televised appearance.
Well, it looks like a mismatch, but wait a minute. Parker Bohn, even though he's been there many, many times, I guarantee you, he's nervous too.
Bohn, first shot here in the title match. And it's a strike.
He just doesn't show his nerves.
Marshall, I believe your first title, one of your first two titles against Billy Hardwick, I believe. I mean, you had to be a little bit nervous going up against a veteran that has won some championships.
Well, there's no doubt about it. Now, you know, I made a lot of telecasts, and I was always nervous. The first one and the 100th one. We take our first look at John May.
Oh, nice shot.
Well, loosen him up a little bit. You know, he didn't just get to be the tournament leader because he's a nice guy, and he is a nice guy, but, you know, he out-bowled the competition, and he did it right from the get-go. He was third the first round and then led the tournament every round after that.
Points leader in the Southern region the last 3 years. He's won 14 regional titles, still looking for his first PBA win.
Well, ball comes in light, leaves the two and the five. Well, now let's take a look at what's in the bag. And what's in the bag for John May is the Parker Bohn MVP ball. This is the ball that John used all week. It gives John a mid-lane reaction with smoothness. And the ball's a little bit, the lanes are a little tighter today. So we put a little surface on the ball, give it a little more adhesion to the lane. And he's using a spare ball, Brunswick spare ball as well.
So Bohn,
the target zone.
Strike. As Bohn now up, and he has just a 7-pin.
Ball coming in light, and the pins racing all over the place. Bohn switching to a ball that goes a lot straighter. And no problem. Here's the first shot Parker threw. Watch the head pin go to the sideboard and then kick him back in front of the 7-pin.
Well, we're all even through a couple of frames. Strike, spare for both players.
And Bohn knows that if he gets off to a hot start, it just makes it that much more difficult on May. Puts more pressure on the relative unknown.
And it's a strike for Bohn. So, strike, spare, strike to start the championship match. For May, high game 268 this week, low of 171. On this TV pair, just 208 average. Boy, he's strong.
Fortunate, just the 6 and the 10, and John's got a lot of support here. You know, he lives in Iron Station, North Carolina. That's only about four and a half hours away. He told me it's in the Charlotte area.
27-year-old trying to pick up the spare here in the third.
Switching to a harder ball. Good technique on the spare.
So through three frames, Parker Bohn on top by just two.
And, you know, the toughest thing for a newcomer like May is just to allow his natural ability to happen. That's what the nerves can do to you. Well, comes in high on lane 30, comes in light on lane 29, and he's going to need to settle down. Still, Bohn does not have a double, so it's just going to be a three-pin deficit for May with a spare here in the fourth frame.
And picks up the spare. So May, a good thing, he's picking up his spares. That may loosen you up just a little bit.
Well, Bohn taking a re-rack on lane 30. Didn't like the way the pins were set. Probably the one and the two. As you can see, Bohn came from way off the pace, and he was in 15th place with one round to go, Phil. Made that great run to get to the eighth spot.
Here he is, shooting for another title. He has 22. And, nope.
Six pin, not going to fall over. Pretty much the what happened, you know, in the first match, he bowled that great 279, struggled a little bit in the second match. Now he's starting to struggle again. As you can see, this ball creeping up ever so high. A little interference there, or that other pin would have come over and knocked the six down. But Bohn to maintain a three-pin advantage.
And it's the first time in this eight-player format this year that a player has advanced and won three matches and gets to the title match.
Well, so difficult with all the numbers you have to go through to make it from the first match to the last. But, you know, I really like Parker's chances today as well as Norm Duke if he could have won the first match, because those two players both have so much confidence in their games.
Fifth frame, and it's a strike.
Well, no problem on lane 29 for Bohn, but certainly having trouble with lane 30. Ball's going to be coming right at you. It goes right about over the sixth board. He's moved in a little bit since the first game. Finishes right where you want it.
They started off this title match with a strike. Now three spares up in the fifth frame.
He likes it. He'll show you some emotion. He's an animated young man.
I like that shot with a strike in the fifth. Still trails by three.
And his bowling goals before this week were to make a telecast. Well, he's got to set new goals. He's done that.
He's got to hurry, and boy, just the two pin.
Ball sliding out. You know, as more games are bowled, more oil is sent down to the back end of the lane, and the ball just will not hook back into the pocket quite as aggressively. He needs to make the adjustment.
Keeps kind of glancing to the left before he sets his eyes on the target. Throws and picks up the spare. So John May hanging tough here in the championship match of the Chattanooga Open. There you see it. May up by three, or down by three. To frame, trying to make it a double. And extend that lead to 13.
Good shot.
Yeah!
Boy, I knew it off his hand, and believe me, Parker knew it a split second before I did. That was just vintage Parker Bohn III. Great delivery, great projection down the lane, ball hooking into the pocket, and the positive reaction of a man who's going for his 23rd title. Something, by the way, I've never done.
Well, still have time.
It's okay.
You know?
It's okay. You can see Parker Bohn III last year, 232 plus. That's a tidy chunk.
Almost as much as you hit. And Parker, the seven pin, and it's going to stand up there.
Well, not. Watch the pins. Watch the head pin. Goes to the sideboard, but it comes in front of the seven pin. Saw a lot of that in the last couple of days. Parker switching balls, hard to straight at the seven.
And Parker picks up the spare for Bohn. Boy, he's getting ready for his tournament next week. It's the Parker Bohn III Empire State Open. He won there in Latham at Bowlers Club last year. As you can see, Parker Bohn on top by 12, and the Junior Pro-Am tomorrow there at the Bowlers Club, and Tuesday the Adult Pro-Am. It's always fun when you bowl with the amateurs and have a good time, huh?
You bet.
May now has to get it going here in the seventh. Light.
Will it knock it down? Tries to knock down the two pin, but he's been coming in light a lot. There's Buster and Sue May, John's parents, and well, they got to be nervous too, watching their boy out there trying to win his first national title.
And again, he's won 14 regional titles, but a little bit different.
Well, he's got to figure out a way to start striking. First the spare, he makes it. We got a pin missing on lane 29, so they're going to have to get a re-rack. There we go. We get a re-rack on 29, get a full 10 for John May. And
hockey's best take the ice in Toronto as ABC Sports brings you the NHL All-Star Game presented by Nortel Networks. Come celebrate a century of great hockey as North America's best take on the world's best today at 2:30 live on ABC Sports. May up in the eighth frame.
Oh, he's moved his trajectory. He moved inside, and he strikes. Had to make some kind of an adjustment. He made the right one. Got away from that hang spot on the right side of the lane. You can see he's deeper in on the lane. Ball over the 14 board. Now driving back into the pocket and just destroying him. About time. You know, he's only down by 13.
Pin lead for Parker. Brings it back and sets it in there in the eighth frame. A strike for Bohn, who's trying to make it a clean sweep here in Chattanooga, winning four matches.
Bohn coming in, flushing the pocket again and loving it.
Could really put the heat on.
Well, this
John.
Next shot, but he knew that was good off his hand. This one here could go a long way to wrapping up his 23rd PBA championship.
Got it out. And yes!
Seven ball.
Oh, my.
Left the seven pin last time on lane 29. But this time, watch the four pin go into the channel. Just nudge it out. And the demonstrative reaction from Parker Bohn III.
May comes right back.
Arrow, is he starting too late, Phil?
Yeah, we got the 10th frame upcoming here, possible 226.
John May has the opportunity for 226. That would force Parker Bohn to strike in the 10th frame to win the tournament.
Well, you said he had moved a couple of frames ago, right?
He moved in. He moved further in. This man hasn't moved. He just keeps doing what he's doing, but May move further left on the approach. Hold on. Four pin. Yeah, that could seal his fate right there.
Well, he got it out a couple of times on that lane and just didn't quite make it back up. This time leaves just the four pin.
205, the best John May can do. Bold a quality game for his first game on television. Doesn't look like it's going to be enough as Parker Bohn III.
Needs high count on that first shot.
Yeah, just needs to get nine pins on the first ball. Depending on what John May does here. Needs a strike here. Well, it's a 6 and the 10.
203 for John May. Makes it a little easier for Parker to wrap up his 23rd. National title and pass Marshall Holman.
We were stuck there for a couple months.
It's okay. Quit rubbing it in, Phil.
I have zero titles. Parker taking a little extra time. Needs just nine pins.
They're resetting the lane on 29. He's just waiting for that so he can have the opportunity to have some composure.
Well, last year it was about the fourth tournament where he got it going. This is the fourth stop.
That's light. Yeah! And that's your winner right there.
Parker Bohn III in the 10th frame. Looked like it was going to be a little line. It was, but
well, it very well could have been the 3 and the 7. But Parker got enough of the head pin, and there's title number 23. And it must be kind of nice to win a tournament and then go to the next week and have the tournament named for you.
Parker Bohn III coming through. He won four matches
this afternoon here in Chattanooga at Holiday Bowl Brainerd. Parker Bohn III, your winner. On ESPN has been brought to you by Brunswick. Get the power of proactive only from Brunswick. And by Just for Men. Just for Men blends away gray hair in 5 minutes. Looks so natural, no one can tell. Well, your winner, Parker Bohn III, 226-203 over John May.
All right, now it's time for our Ginkoma moment of concentration. Let's take a look back at the key moment in today's tournament, and it was Parker Bohn III. He needed 9 in the 10th frame, and boy, he sucked it up. He knew exactly where he was, able to get it done. Great shot. That's today's Ginkoma moment of concentration. Think better, think Ginkoba. Congratulations to Parker Bohn III, his 23rd PBA title.
That's right, he won the Chattanooga Open here, 226-203. Please join us next week as the PBA Tour returns to the Greater Albany area for the second consecutive year with the Parker Bohn III Empire State Open at Boulders Club. Catch all the action on ESPN at 12 noon. Coming up next, women's soccer, USA versus Norway. Old Parker Bohn, a thrilling victory this afternoon. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For more, log on to ESPN.com. Part of the Go Network, go.com.